everyone. This is going to be my first and probably only reading of My Immortal, probably the worst Harry Potter fanfiction to ever be created. There's more than one chapter per page, and I'm going to be playing some quote-unquote gothic music for this gothic story written by an ever-so-gothic girl. I hope you guys enjoy. Sorry, no. Okay, maybe I should play Evanescence. Just for y'all, I will, because Evanescence is so gothic. Yeah. By the way, say hi to my friend Hap. She's on here too.
Hello, people.
And Aaron just came back from peeing.
Butts. And ice cream.
That's nice.
I have ice cream. Be jelly.
I am jelly.
It's birthday cake ice cream.
Our starting off song is like Haunted by Evanescence from the special album Anywhere But Home.
Okay.
Chapters 1 and 2. Chapter 1. Anne. Special fangs. Get it? Cause I'm gothic. To my GF. Ew, not in that way. Raven, bloody tears, 666, for helping me with the story and spelling. You rock. Justin, you're the love of my derbzing life. You rock too. MCR rocks, because everything just fucking rocks, bitches. Hi, my name is Ebony Darkness Dementia Raven Way, and I have long ebony black hair. That's how I got my name. With purple streaks and red tips that reach my mid-back, and icy blue eyes like limpid tears, and a lot of people tell me I look like Amy Lee. A.N. If you don't know who she is, get the hell out of here. I'm not related to Gerard Way, but I wish I was, because he's a major fucking hottie. I'm a vampire, but my teeth are straight and white. I have pale white skin. I'm also a witch, and I go to magic school. I go to a magic school called Hogwarts in England, where I'm in seventh year. I'm 17. I'm a goth, in case you couldn't tell, and I wear mostly black. I love Hot Topic, and I buy all my clothes from there. For example, today I'm wearing.
I don't think they have a Hot Topic in England.
I don't think they do either, but whatever.
Internet.
You can have it imported or whatever. I don't know. Fuck my vagina ass. Sorry. Okay. For example, today I was wearing a black corset with matching lace around it and a black leather miniskirt, pink fishnets, and black combat boots. Because everyone knows that combat boots are meant to be worn with civilian clothing. No, you dumb shit. Combat boots are supposed to be at least two sizes bigger than your regular shoe size. They're not cute. They're meant to be protective and, frankly, very dangerous. But you disrespect the uniform, why don't you, you cunt? Sorry. I was wearing black lipstick, white foundation, black eyeliner, and red eyeshadow. I was walking outside Hogwarts. It was snowing and raining, so there was no sun, which I was very happy about. A lot of preps stared at me. I put up my middle finger at them. "Hey, Ebony," shouted a voice. I looked up. It was Draco Malfoy. "What's up, Draco?" I asked. "Nothing," he said shyly. But then I heard my friends call me and I had to go away. Anne, is it good? Please tell me, Fangs. Chapter 2. Yes, that was a whole fucking chapter.
Seriously?
Don't you just want to piss yourself?
Oh, yeah. I'm about to pee in anticipation.
And
pee before.
Casually scrolls through Tumblr, not caring.
A.N. Fangs to bloody tears 666 for helping me with the chapter. BTW, preps, stop filming my story, okay? The next day I woke up in my bedroom. It was snowing and raining again. I opened the door of my coffin and drank some blood from a bottle I had. My coffin was black ebony, and inside it was hot pink velvet with black lace on the ends. I got out of my coffin and took of my giant MCR t-shirt, which I used for pajamas. Instead, I put on a black leather dress, a pentagram necklace, combat boots with black fishnets on. You know, that wasn't even a full fucking sentence. Whoever her English teacher is, I'm going to, like, murder them in their sleep.
Can I assist?
Yes, please. I put on 4 pairs of earrings and my pierced ears, and put my hair in a kind of messy bun. Yes, yes, because messy buns look sexy and they don't make you look like a slob at all. My friend Willow, and Raven, this is you. I woke up and then grinned at me. She flipped her long, waist-length raven black hair with pink streaks and opened her forest green eyes. She put on her Marilyn Manson t-shirt with a black mini, fishnets, and pointy high-heeled boots. We put on our makeup, black lipstick with white foundation and black eyeliner. Same as every fucking day, because there's no fucking variety, and y'all are so fucking gothic, which means you have to use fucking black all the time, because you're all fucking fuckasses. Oh, MFG, I saw you talking to Draco Malfoy yesterday, she said excitedly. Yeah, so? I said, blushing. Do you like Draco? She asked as she went out of the Slytherin common room into the Great Hall. No, I so fucking don't, I shouted. Yeah, right, she exclaimed. Just then, Draco walked up to me. Hi, he said. Hi, I replied flirtily. Guess what, he said. What, I asked. Well, good Charlotte are having a concert in Hogsmeade, he told me. Oh my fucking god, I screamed. I love GC, they're my favorite band, besides MCR. Well, do you want to go with me, he asked. I gasped. I think that's the end of the fucking chapter. That's the end of the fucking chapter. Oh my fucking god.
Wow.
Alright, oh my god, there's 35 chapters to this shit.
Haha, you have to read all of them.
And it's infamous.
Oh yeah, it should be fucking infamous. Chapter 3. And stop flaming the story, prebs, okay? Otherwise, fangs to the gothic people for the good reviews. Fangs again, Raven. Oh yeah, BTW, I don't own this or the lyrics for Good Charlotte. What the fuck? On the night of the concert, I put on my black lace-up boots with high heels. What? Boots with high... You're smart. I'm sorry. I put on my black lace-up boots with high heels. I'm gonna slap a bitch. Underneath them were ripped red fishnets. Then I put on a black leather mini dress with all this corset stuff on the back and front. You know, I normally don't get pissed. I normally don't get pissed that easily, but you know, there are certain things you should and should know when you're talking about clothes. I'm sorry if I'm coming off as a cunt, but it's called tight lacing. Or you could say lacing detail, or something that shows that you have a vocabulary above the level of a second grader, you cunt! Sorry.
It's cool.
Not really. I'm probably gonna have to edit this out.
Nah, don't. This is great.
I put on matching fishnet on my arms. I straightened my hair and made it look all spiky. That's not how you spell spiky. And if you straighten your hair, it doesn't look spiky. It looks straight. Nah. Oh my god. What? I don't even.
It's with Joe.
Yeah,
but she said she had, like, waist... If you have fucking waist-length hair, how the fuck do you make it look spiky? Unless you have bangs and then you spike those up, but then you look like a retard.
Then you look like a retard!
Maybe so that's what she is. She
I felt a little depressed then, so I slit one of my wrists. I read a depressing book while I waited for it to stop bleeding, and I listened to some GC. Because that's what everyone does after they cut themselves from feeling depressed. They calmly read a fucking book.
Yeah, they don't don't even bother to, you know, clean it up.
Or they don't bother to freak out, or they don't bother to cry, or they don't bother to show that they're in some sort of fucking pain. Whenever I cut myself, it fucking hurt. I was crying like a little fucking bitch. I didn't go read. I stayed in my fucking bathtub and tried to wash away the evidence.
Wait, yeah. What?
Nothing. Never mind. Just forget I said that.
Bad.
Shut up. It wasn't recently, Aaron. Yeah. I painted my nails black and put on tons of black eyeliner. Oh yeah, because that won't make you look like a slut. Then I put on some black lipstick. I didn't put on foundation because I was pale anyways. Then why wear foundation in the first place, you bastard bitch fucking pussy slut? Sorry, that didn't make sense. I want to cry. I drank some human blood, so I was ready to go to the concert. I went outside. Draco was waiting there in front of his flying car. He was wearing a Simple Plan t-shirt. They would play at the show, too. Baggy black skater pants, black nail polish, and a little eyeliner. A-N. A lot of cool boys wear it, okay? Hi, Draco, I said in a depressed voice. Hi, Ebony, he said back. We walked to his flying black Mercedes-Benz. The license plate said 666. Oh, yes, because that's so fucking original, you cunt. And flew to the place with the concert. On the way, we listened excitedly to Good Charlotte and Marilyn Manson. We both smoked cigarettes and drugs. Yes, because that's what every fucking person does on their way to a concert. When we got there, we both hopped out of the car. We went into the mosh pit and in front of the stage and jumped up and down as we listened to Good Charlotte. Okay. You come in cold, you're covered in blood. They're all so happy you arrived. The doctor cuts your cord, hands to your mom. She sets you free into this life, saying, Joel, I don't own the lyrics to that song. Joel is so fucking hot, I said to Draco, pointing to him as he sung, filling the club with his amazing voice. Suddenly, Draco looked sad. What's wrong? I asked as we moshed to the music. Then I caught on. Hey, it's okay. I don't like him better than you, I said. Really? Draco asked sensitively, and he put his arm around me all protective. Really, I said. Besides, I don't even know Joel, and he's going out with that Hillary fucking Duff. I fucking hate that little bitch, I said disgustedly, thinking of her ugly blonde face. Okay, there's nothing wrong with blonde people. Hillary Duff isn't ugly. She's at least average looking.
I just don't like Hillary Duff because... Nah.
I mean, if you don't like her, that's fine. If you don't like, you know, her music or her material, that's cool, but... You know.
Yeah, the reason I don't like her has nothing to do with her looks. I think she is very loose, inappropriate.
Oh, I don't know, because I don't listen to her music, so I don't give a fuck.
This is what I hear from the news.
Oh, I don't give a fuck. I don't hear shit from the news. Okay. The night went on really well, and I had a great time. So did Draco. After the concert, we drank some beer and asked Benji and Joel for their autographs and a photo with them. We got GC concert tees. Draco and I crawled back to the Mercedes. Okay, but Draco didn't go back into Hogwarts. Instead, he drove the car into the Forbidden Forest.
Oh no!
They mean the Dark Forest.
I don't know. A.N. Chapter 4. A.N. I said stop flaming, okay? Ebony's name is Enobi. Not Mary Sue, okay? Draco is so in love with her that he is acting different. Day knew Etchotter before, okay? Okay. Point taken, Miss A.N., whatever. Draco, I shouted, what the fuck do you think you're doing? Draco didn't answer, but he stopped the flying car and walked out of it. I walked out of it too, curiously. What the fucking hell? I asked angrily. Ebony, he asked. What? Draco leaned in extra close, and I looked into his gothic red eyes. He was wearing color contacts, which revealed so much depressing sorrow and evilness, and then I didn't feel mad anymore. And then, suddenly, just as I, Draco kissed me passionately, Draco climbed on top of me, and we started to make out keenly against a tree. He took off my top, and I took off his clothes. I even took off my bra. And then he put his thingy into my you-know-what, and we did it for the first time. Oh, 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 ah, I screamed. I was beginning to get an orgasm. We started to kiss everywhere, and my pale body became all warm. And then, what the hell are you doing, you motherfuckers? It was Dumbledore. She spelled fuckers wrong. Okay, chapters 5 and 6. Wait, right, who's Alex? Okay. Who's Alex Blue?
Oh, that's remember Alex from Tiny Chat?
Okay, that's him. Good.
Quiet, dude.
You can add him to the call if you want so we can hear this shit. All right, tell me when he's on so I can start. tell him what I'm doing.
No, he knows what you're reading. I told him. He's like, oh, well, she's in for an interesting, crappy story.
My God. Chapter 5. A.N. Stop flaming. If you flam, it means you're a prep or a poser. The only reason Dumbledore swore is cause he had a headache, okay? And on top of that, he was mad at them for having sex. P.S. I'm not updating until I get 5 good revoils.
Yay!
Alright.
I'm gonna buy him into call. Hold on. He's like, you want in con? You want in con? He's like, yeah.
Alright. You so fucking cunt. You shouldn't have gotten any good reviews.
Okay, continue, hon.
Alright. Dumbledore made and Draco and I follow him. He kept shouting at us angrily. You ludicrous fools! He shouted. I started to cry tears of blood down my pallid face. Draco comforted me. When we went back to the castle, Dumbledore took us to Professor Snape and Professor McGonagall, who were both looking very angry. They were having sexual intercourse in the Forbidden Forest, he yelled in a furious voice. Why did you do such a thing, you mediocre dunces? Asked Professor McGonagall. How dare you, demanded Professor Snape. And then Draco shrieked, because I love her! What? Everyone was quiet. Dumbledore and Professor McGonagall still looked mad, but Professor Snape said, fine, very well, you may go up into your rooms. What the fuck? No! No, if I was caught having sex in the middle of a forest...
guys, Roman.
What?
Hold on. Okay. We should do a drinking game.
Oh my God.
Seriously.
I'm gonna be drunk by the time I'm done reading this shit. And it might not be because I lose the game, it might...
Wait, hold on, which one would you prefer, Alex? The misspelling, or every time Roman stops to say how retarded the story is? Dude, we can hear you, bro, just say it.
Yeah, wait. just say it, bro.
Just talk, dude, just talk.
Alright. Yeah, I'd say, when Roman also has to think about how retarded the story is.
Okay. I've got my drink already, so...
Dude, I'm not drinking any alcohol, because my mom's gonna come home, and she's gonna see me all drunk, and she's gonna be like, what the fuck?
I only have soda.
Alright, as I was saying, if I got caught having sex in the middle of a forest, I would lose my vagina, or it would be sewn shut. And I'm pretty sure that the guy that was fucking me would lose his cock.
Ouch, still?
Alright, I'm sorry, it's just, that's...
Yeah.
Okay, let's continue. Let's continue. Hap, shut up. Draco and I went upstairs while the teachers glared at us. "Are you okay, Ebony?" Draco asked me gently. "Yeah, I guess," I lied. I went to the girls' dorm and brushed my teeth and my hair and changed into my low-cut black floor-length dress with red lace all around it and black high heels. When I came out, Draco was standing in front of the bathroom and he started to sing "I Just Want to Live" by Good Charlotte. I was so flattered, even though he wasn't supposed to be there. We hugged and kissed after that. After that, we said goodnight and he reluctantly went back to his room. Yay, no more sex. Chapter 6. Shidget up, Rebs, okay? P.S. I will not update up till you give me good revows. The next day, I woke up in my coffin. I put on a black miniskirt that was all ripped around the end and a matching top with red skulls all over it and high-heeled boots that were black. Thank you! You finally learned, cunt. I put on two pairs of skull earrings and two crosses in my ears. I spray painted my hair with purple. In the great hall, I ate some Count Chocula cereal with blood instead of milk and a glass of red blood. It's just blood on top of chocolate cereal.
Which is disgusting, by the way.
Wait, it's red blood too.
Oh no.
So what, she's drinking Carcat's blood?
There's more than one color blood.
Count Chocula is so mad.
Hey guys, at least it wasn't mustard blood.
Hey.
Wanna see my double thongs?
There's nothing wrong with having mustard blood.
We know.
Alright. Suddenly, someone bumped into me. All the blood spilled all over my top. Bastard! I shouted angrily. I regretted saying it when I looked up because I was looking into the pale white face of a gothic boy with spiky black hair with red streaks in it. Oh, this must be the counter love interest. He was wearing so much eyeliner that I was going down his face and he was wearing black lipstick. Okay. He didn't have glasses anymore and now he was wearing red contact lenses just like Draco's and there was no scar on his forehead anymore. He had a manly stubble on his chin.
This fanfic is legal.
It's legal.
A manly stubble.
Actually, I think fanfiction.net took it down for bad quality.
Still on here. It's still it on here.
Oh god, what the fuck?
He had a sexy English accent. He looked exactly like Joel Madden. He was so sexy that my body went all hot when I saw him. Kind of like an erection, only I'm a girl, so I don't get one, you sicko. "I'm so sorry," he said in a shy voice. "That's all right. What's your name?" I questioned. "My name's Harry Potter." What the fuck? Although most people call me a vampire these days. What the fuck? Why? I exclaimed. "Because I love the taste of human blood," he giggled. Oh, giggled. Hee!
I'm Harry Potter.
Well, I'm a vampire, I confessed. Really? He whimpered. Yeah, I roared. I mean, yeah! We sat down to talk for a while. Then Draco came up behind me and told me he had a surprise for me, so I went away with him. Okay, chapters 7-9. Reposter's note. I also forgot to mention that you should read some of the commentaries people write here. They're hilarious. All right, I will. Chapter 7. Bring me to life. A.N. Well, okay, you guys. I'm only writing this because I got 5 god reviews. In BTW, I won't write that next chapter till I get 10 god bonds. Oh, is she trying to be Austrian now? Come on, bitch. Let me hear your accent. Stow, flaming, or I'll report you. Ebony isn't a Mary Sue, okay? She isn't perfect. She's a Satanist. No, she's a Satan tits or Satanist.
This is so bad.
Oh my god.
And oh my she god. Has problems. She's depressed for God's sake. Wow.
Gonna be Satan's sake.
Yeah. Or Satan's sake. It's spelled the same way. Draco and I held our pale white hands with black nail polish as we went upstairs. I was wearing red Satanist signs or sayings on my nails and red nail polish. A.N. See, does that sound like a Mary Sue to you? I waved.
Do you even know the definition of Mary Sue?
Probably not, and I don't give a fuck.
I want to enjoy my ice cream now.
I waved to a vampire. Dark misery was in his depressed eyes. I guess he was jealous of me that I was going out with Draco. Anyway, I went upstairs excitedly with Draco. We went into his bedroom and he locked the door. Then, .. We started Frenching passively. Passively? Oh my fucking god! Guys, hold on, I'm gonna pause because this is terrible and I need an egg roll.
Well, still better love story than Twilight.
Birthday cake ice cream.
Nice.
I am awesome. Dude, ow. Nipple. Why?
I bet Roman's gonna have PTSD after this.
What'd I miss? Alright, got some Coke. And not the kind that, you know, is bad for you. Aaron, why did you just say my nipple? By the way, speaking of nipples, mine kind of itches.
I don't know why, but it just does. It's weird. There's something under my tush. Oh.
Alright. Now that I shoved an egg roll in my mouth, I'm ready to go.
Okay, well, I'm figuring out what clothes to get my new fan drill.
Cool.
Better involve the door.
We started Frenching passively, and we took off each other's clothes enthusiastically. He felt me up before I took off my top. Then I took off my black leather bra, and he took off his pants. We went on the bed and started making out naked. Then he put his boy's thingy in mine, and we had sex. See, is that stupid? Yes, because you basically said you had a penis!
What did she say?
Then he put his... concept. No, here. Then he put his boy's thingy in mine. That's implying that y'all have the same kind of thingy. A penis going inside a penis.
Is that called docking or something?
I don't know. Oh, Draco! Draco! I screamed while getting an orgasm.
Oh my God.
When all of a sudden I saw a tattoo I had never seen on Draco's arm. It was a black heart with an arrow through it. On it in bloody gothic writing were the words vampire. That's one word, you stupid bitch. I was so angry. You bastard! I shouted angrily, jumping out of the bed. No, no, but you don't understand, Draco pleaded. But I knew too much. No, you fucking idiot, I shouted. You probably have AIDS anyway. But he just put his penis inside of your penis, so you have it too. Sorry. Oh, God. I put on my clothes all huffily and then stomped out. Draco ran out even though he was naked. He had a really big you-know-what. But I was too mad to care. I stomped out and did so until I was in Vampire's classroom where everyone was having a lesson with Professor Snape and some other people. Vampire Potter, you motherfucker, I yelled.
What?
Oh, wait, yeah, because Harry's new name is Vampire.
Yeah. Oh, God, that just... Oh.
Chapter 8. A-N.
Boy swings it.
Stop flassing, okay? If you do, then you're a prep. Okay.
Okay.
Everyone in the class stared at me, and then Draco came in the room, even though he was naked, and started begging me to take him back. Ebony, it's not what you think! Excuse me, I had to burp. Draco screamed sadly. You can scream sadly. Oh, yeah. Oh, God, I'm sorry. It's torturing me. My friend, Bloody Mary Smith, the fuck, smiled at me understatedly. She flipped her long waist... Huh?
Apparently that's Hermione.
Really? Okay.
Really.
She flipped her long waist-length black gothic hair and opened her crimson eyes like blood that she was wearing contact lenses on. She had pale white skin that she was wearing white makeup on. Hermione was kidnapped when she was born. Her real parents are vampires, and one of them is a witch. But Voldemort killed her mother, and her father committed suicide because she was depressed about it.
What?
Apparently, her dad is a
I don't know. She still has nightmares about it. She is very haunted and depressed. It also turns out her real last name is Smith and not Granger. Since she has converted to Satanism, she is in Slytherin now, not Gryffindor. Wow! So if you're a Satanist, you're automatically in Slytherin?
God, no wonder they were pretty much the bad guys in every movie and book.
Oh man, this is.
Oh my God.
Man, fuck it.
People are like getting nommed on in this movie.
Yeah.
There's something I want to ask y'all.
What?
Do each of y'all know what class? I mean, not house. Class. What house in Harry Potter y'all would fall under?
Slytherin.
Hufflepuff.
I'm in Slytherin. I found out through Pottermore.
I took some test and it told me Slytherin. I was like, fuck yeah, Slytherin.
Yeah.
I'm not a Satanist, by the way. To all my viewers, I'm Roman Catholic. And I'm still in Slytherin, apparently, so fuck you.
Hey, I'm a nice person and I'm in Slytherin.
Yeah, I'm not a nice person. What is it that you desire, you ridiculous dimwit? Snape demanded angrily in his cold voice, but I ignored him. Vampire, I can't believe you cheated on me with Draco, I shouted at him. What?
Vampire?
But and not Draco, she vampire? Was supposed she was having sex with Draco and then she met Harry slash vampire, so how did that even
That's what I'm asking. How can she say
Harry I don't know. I don't give a fucking fuck. Suck my motherfucking cock. I'm gonna keep reading.
Remember that song?
Suck my dick. Suck my motherfucking dick.
What did I walk into?
I love you, Alex.
Oh my God. Alex, I'm sorry. I don't know why Ebony was so mad at me. I had went out with... Oh, apparently this is in Draco's point of view now. I had...
Sure, let's go with it.
Yeah. I went out with Vampire, I'm bi, and so is Ebony, for a while, and then he broke my heart. He dumped me because he liked Brittany, a stupid preppy fucker. We were just good friends now. He had gone through terrible problems, and now he was gothic. Haha, I like how I hang out with a prep. What? I would hang out with a prep, Mo. She probably thinks preps are anyone that doesn't wear black.
Wasn't a good Charlotte, or
yeah,
just, or constantly slit their wrists.
Yeah, they need no.
I remember when that used to be the stereotype for goth.
It's not even the stereotype for goth. It's supposedly emo. It's not even emo. Emo is a music style. The slitting the wrist thing was considered new wave. And new wave is a style of music, but new wave is also a passing trend and theme. You know, I'm going to get too far into this. Let me just keep reading. I'll read through all of this in chapter 9, and then we can have a discussion. All right.
Good plan.
Yeah. But I'm not going out with Draco anymore, said Vampire. Yeah, fucking right. Fuck off, you bastard, I screamed. Wait, so I is referring to Ebony and Drake. Okay. I get it. It's stupid, but I get it.
Wait, can you reread that? I got confused.
Yeah, fucking right. Fuck off, you bastard, I screamed.
Go back a little bit more.
Okay. Vampire, I can't believe he cheated on me with Draco, I shouted at him. Everyone gasped.
Oh.
I don't...
So wait, so there's Yaoi in this.
Yes, there's gay sex.
And he was raped by a wheelchair.
He was raped by a wheelchair.
What line haven't we crossed at this point?
We've crossed all the lines.
Oh my god. Okay. I ran out of the room into the forbidden forest where I had lost my virility to Draco, and then I started to burst into tears. Chapter 9. A.N. Stop flaming, okay? I didn't read all the box. This is from the movie, okay? It's not my fault if Dumbledore swears. Bizoids. I said he had a headache. And a resin snap doesn't like lick Harry. What? Is now is cause he's Christian and vampire is a Satanist. MCR rocks.
I think I just. What?
I don't know. I was so mad and sad. I couldn't believe Draco for cheating on me. I began to cry against the tree where I did it with Draco. The fuck?
Why would you
just go back to the tree?
How does she know the specific tree?
They did that in a tree. They did that in a tree.
They did it in the tree. Okay, that's even worse.
Then all of us.
Three people.
Oh my god, no, you're... Oh no, Terezi, I'm sorry.
Terezi?
Terezi is a tree person.
She's a tree elf!
Alright. Then, all of a sudden, an horrible man with red eyes had no nose and everything started flying towards me on a broomstick. What? He didn't have a nose, basically like Voldemort in the movie. And he was wearing all black, but it was obvious he wasn't gothic. It was Voldemort. No! I shouted in a scared voice. But then Voldemort shouted, Imperius! And I couldn't run away. Crookshanks! What? I shouted at him. Voldemort fell off of his broom and started to scream. I felt bad for him even though I'm a sadist, so I stopped. If you're a sadist, you'd continue. Ebony, he yelled, thou must kill Vampire Potter. I thought about what? Vampire and his sexy eyes and his gothic black hair and how his face looks just like Joel Madden. I remembered that Draco had said that I didn't understand. So I thought, what if Draco went out with a vampire before I went out with him and they broke up? No, Voldemort, I shouted back. Voldemort gave me a gun. No, please, I begged. Thou must wait. They use guns now. Okay. If
yeah,
thou.
Remember that part in the story where Voldemort starts speaking in old English and pointing guns at everyone?
Yeah, that was my favorite part, man.
Holy.
I don't understand what's going on.
Thou must, he yelled. If thou dost not, then I shall kill thy beloved Draco. How did you know? I asked in a surprised way. Voldemort got a, dude, you're so retarded look on his face. I would too, bitch! I have telekinesis. That's not even the right... Okay. He answered cruelly. And if you doth not kill vampire, then thou know what will happen to Drago, he shouted. Then he flew away angrily on his broomstick.
His broomstick?
Hold on. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I want to take a ride on your disco stick. Don't think too much. Just thrust that stick.
That was it, Amanda.
next song, we're listening to Lady Gaga.
Well, we can't really listen to Lady Gaga now, can we?
If you'll go into my stream, y'all can.
I don't want to listen to Lady Gaga. Yeah. Honestly, I don't like...
I don't care. Let's just keep reading. I was so scared and mad, I didn't know what to do. Suddenly, Drago came into the woods. Drago, I said. Hi! Hi, he said back. His face was all sad. He was wearing white foundation and messy eyeliner. Kind of like a pentagram. Get it? Between Joel Madden and Gerard White. What? That makes no sense.
Sure, that makes perfect sense.
Are you okay? I asked. No, he answered. I'm sorry I got all mad at you, but I thought you cheated on me, I expelled. That's okay, he said all depressed, and we went back into Hogwarts together, making out. I'm going to fucking slit some fucking throats. Oh, fuck my vagina. Okay. Chapters 10 through 12 will be read in a minute. I need a little while to recuperate because I am low on oxygen. I've been holding my breath a good portion of the time. See you all later, listeners. I hope you have enjoyed my pain. Because I'm gothic and I listen to Evanescence and I am fucking depressed and I slit my wrists and cry while reading books. Alright, bye. See y'all later. This has been Elle Romanov, and thank you for watching AK Jackson's 47's Play Paint Fun.